Commerce Committee. Congressman, you've been questioning Mary Barra, the CEO at GM. Are you happy with her responses? Tell me what you've learned so far.
Well, I'm not pleased with the responses, Maria, simply that there weren't really meaty responses. In fact, we're learning a lot more from the documents that GM is providing us than we did from her testimony.
What are you learning from the documents?
Well, the documents are showing us that GM knew that their switch, the ignition switch, was faulty and non-compliant as early as 2004. We also learned from those documents that in 2001, the engineers chose between two different models of ignitions, and chose one mostly based on its cheaper cost. Interestingly, the one they rejected is now the one they're putting in to replace the faulty one.
And that, of course, the more expensive one, but initially they didn't want to pay off.
Yes.
Okay, so they were trying to save money. Let me ask you, because part of the time that we are talking about when these ignition switch problems were happening, the company was in bankruptcy protection. We all know that the government bailed out GM after the 2008 crisis. Will they be able to use bankruptcy protection, given they were in bankruptcy after this event, these troubles, will they be able to use bankruptcy protection to shield them from customer lawsuits?
Well, it seems like they're trying, and I'm very disappointed. In fact, I'm learning that the, quote, this is the new GM, this isn't the old GM. The new GM really means post-bankruptcy and that they don't want to recognize any liabilities from before they filed the bankruptcy in 2009. And so now I understand Barra's testimony in more clarity, since they have clarified they aren't going to recognize. They are going to use the bankruptcy to try and escape liability. I wish they'd change their decision on it.
Wow. I mean, wouldn't that, though, unleash an incredible, I mean, terrible, at a minimum, PR assault on the company, but perhaps create even more lawsuits?
It will create more lawsuits. I'm glad you brought that up, because traditional bankruptcy law is that the bankruptcy eliminates all of your existing liabilities, and they're saying this liability existed before 2009, therefore it should be wiped out. But the reality is there's many exemptions to that, and hiding liabilities is one of those exemptions, and the lawsuits will focus on whether or not GM was hiding that liability or potential liability.
What are you looking to come out of this? What is your goal in terms of the liability for GM?
Well, if it comes out that GM knew of this defect and made decisions that it was not cost effective, because some of our early document reviews is showing that in 2004 they knew that there was a defect, but yet they said that it wasn't a business model that worked to change it out. That shows me that they may have some liability here, and I wish they'd accept the liability, not accept that it would be wiped out by a bankruptcy. And I want GM to survive this. I want them to be successful. But I think they're really going to hurt their reputation, and there'll be a lot of backlash to GM, maybe even more than taking the bailout, to their reputation. So they've got a lot at risk here for doing it the wrong way.
Congressman, do you think GM survives this?
I think they will survive this, but if they try to escape responsibility for their non-compliant, or now they even call it defective at GM, so I'll use the word defective, if they try and escape responsibility for this, I think the public will punish them.
Right, and real quickly, I mean, for the drivers and people watching at home, should they feel safe with new cars? What should they be thinking, given this high number of recalls?
Well, they should go to the NHTSA website and look to see if they have any recalls on any of their parts. And it's right that most of them aren't going to result in an injury, but just go to the website. If there's a recall, contact the dealership and take your car in.
And that is the National Highway Association website. Good to have you, Congressman.
Yes.
Thanks very much. We will see you soon.
Thank you.
Meanwhile, the Federal Reserve